Welcome to this presentation on psychrometric charts to look at where we're at in the whole scheme of things in this course. I'll move to this slide here. So overall, we're in psychrometrics here, and especially we're looking at charts today, and it's a little bit of applications, but we'll focus on that more next time. All right, but the big focus will be charts, and some of the follow through from principles as they move into using some charts to make things a lot more convenient. What we want to start with is looking at a very practical way that we can find the humidity ratio. So here's our humidity ratio. And we want to see if we can find that in terms of pressure. So just some basic things we can find when we're working with some moist air. Pressure, temperature, this adiabatic saturation temperature, which we'll come back to. And that's it. So those three items. To determine this humidity ratio, we're going to use the situation where we have what's called an adiabatic saturator. So that's what this item is right here, right? Adiabatic saturator. And what we have is we have some moist air coming in, and we have some makeup water sitting down here at the bottom. And as this moist air moves across this makeup water, it's going to pick up more vapor. And as it does, before it exits, it's going to be completely saturated. So that's why I say it's a saturated mixture up top here. And effectively what we're doing, if we look at the TV diagram, all right, with our vapor dome here, we're going to start off here. We're going to have some partial pressure of our vapor. And as we go across the makeup water, we're going to pick up vapor. So we're going to work toward the vapor dome, work toward a saturated condition. But as you notice here, as we go toward the vapor dome, we're actually cooling as well. All right, so we're picking up the water here, and we're cooling as well. So let's write the energy balance equation for this process. So if we look just at the entering air, we have the mass flow rate of the air times the enthalpy of that air, plus the mass flow rate of the vapor times the enthalpy of that vapor. And that's all the entering moist air. All right, and this is probably on your handout if you have it in front of you. Plus, we got the makeup water. So the makeup water is going to be our m dot prime. That's going to be the mass flow rate of stuff leaving of our vapor minus the mass flow rate of the vapor that comes in. So the difference between the two mass flow rates of the vapor, the difference between the mass flow rate here and here would give us the what's coming in at the makeup water. So that's what's shown there. Multiply that times the enthalpy of the water, and that's all makeup water, and equals, we get the mass flow rate of the air times the enthalpy of the air plus the mass flow rate of the vapor prime, right, because it's changed because it picked up some makeup water, all that times the exiting, that is all the exiting moist air. All right, so if we now divide through by the mass flow rate of air, so this is the process we do to get to the humidity ratio. We're going to divide through by the mass flow rate of air. So our equation then becomes the enthalpy of air plus the humidity ratio times the saturated enthalpy value for the vapor, and that's all the stuff entering, plus, again, if we divide through by the mass flow rate of the air, we're going to end up with the humidity ratio prime minus the humidity ratio of the actual air that enters our saturator times the saturated liquid enthalpy. And that's all for the makeup water equals our enthalpy of the air plus the humidity ratio prime times the saturated enthalpy value for the moisture, and that's the exiting. All right, so now if we take this whole equation and we solve for the humidity ratio, we come up with the following. We get our enthalpy of the air times the adiabatic saturation temperature. Now what this adiabatic saturation temperature is, this is an adiabatic saturator, which means there's no heat loss to the environment. There's no energy transfer out of this control volume. And so we're wondering, what is the temperature the adiabatic saturation temperature is the temperature of our fluid at this exit. So we can see here that it cooled down from the temperature of the entering air to where it was saturated, and it was done via an adiabatic process. So that's why it's called the adiabatic saturation temperature. All right, so we'll come back to that more in a bit. But then we have the enthalpy of the air at the initial entering mixture temperature plus the humidity ratio prime times our saturated vapor value times the adiabatic saturation temperature minus the saturated liquid value at the adiabatic saturation temperature, and all that divided by the enthalpy of the saturated vapor at the mixture temperature minus the saturated liquid value at our adiabatic saturation temperature. So let's look a little bit more in depth into our humidity ratio equation. Here's the same equation as was developed before, except here it's a little bit more cleanly presented. And so what I want to highlight here is this adiabatic saturation temperature value here. And again, that's this value right here. So it's the temperature that our mixture cools to, right, if it does, as it goes and picks up this, picks up the makeup water into the vapor. So it becomes a saturated mixture on the exit. So what's interesting about this is if we look at the temperature difference between these two enthalpies. So this is a change in enthalpy, so delta H there. And if that change is small enough, we can represent that as Cp delta T, where the T's are the adiabatic saturation temperature minus the mixture temperature. And this is good because what this does is it takes out having to find both these enthalpies here due to the air, especially this enthalpy due to the adiabatic saturation temperature. And now we're just dealing with adiabatic saturation temperature. We also have this omega prime value that we want to look at too. And the way we can find out this value is by using the partial pressure of the vapor here. All right, so the partial pressure of our vapor that's leaving right here, because this is 0.622, or we looked at this last time, and it's the saturation pressure at the given temperature. So it's the saturation temperature when we're leaving there at omega prime. So that's what the case is right here when we're leaving here with our vapor. And so the denominator is the mixture pressure minus the saturation pressure at that adiabatic saturation temperature. All right, so that we can now find based on the temperature, the adiabatic saturation temperature. That's good, that's helping us. And so now how do we figure out what this adiabatic saturation temperature is? Basically, we gotta find this temperature. What's the temperature of the mixture when it's saturated, when the air is full and it can't hold any more vapor? And the way we do that is with